Here we've got a beautiful lanternfly, a spotted lanternfly in its natural habitat. It's beautiful, isn't it? Actually, it's not. This lanternfly is an invasive species brought to the United States by a stone shipment in 2012. Originally from China, India, and Vietnam, these plant hoppers were first discovered in Berks County, Penn. However, the first New York State infestation was discovered on Staten Island during COVID year of 2020. These pests are just nasty. Matter of fact, they feed on almost 70 different plants, which poses a major threat to agriculture and forestry industries in the New York and Northeast area.
Their favorite place to lay eggs is on the Tree of Heaven. The more they have the sap from this tree and lay their eggs, the more risk the tree is put in. How rude. Just one lanternfly can lay up to 2 egg masses, each containing 30 to 50 eggs.
So when I say these things are invasive, I mean they are invasive.
Hey guys, I'm Ella and welcome to my TED Talk. There are no natural predators here to deplete the population of lanternflies, and since no native organisms have co-evolved with the lanternfly, they have endless opportunity to exponentially grow their population. Don't take my word for it, listen to what the New York Department of Agriculture has to say.
Spotted lanternfly is a pest of apples, grapes, hops, maple, walnut, and others. The maple and timber industries would also be negatively impacted by the spread of SLF.
Remember the last time you used a public restroom?
Now introducing the fly killing pro himself, Henry Field. Baby, bet, hey, couple X, hey,
couple Grammys on you, couple packs. The first step is to identify. The spotted lanternfly is rightfully named with spots on its wings. It has 2 sets of wings. One is red and the other is gray. First nymphs to develop are wingless, black, and have white spots. Its final nymph stage turns red before becoming adults. It's the ugliest bug ever.
Look how hideous.
The second step is to find them. Spotted lanternflies are found in willow, sumac, river birch, grape, rose, and 70 more plants and trees.
Third step is killing with a passion. They are an issue because they feed on a wide variation of plants with their piercing, sucking mouth parts. This results in wilting, leaf curling, and dieback in trees and plants. In the short term, this will limit the amount of crops and trees that remain healthy and are edible. And in the long term, we all die.
Smash, 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 smash. Smash, 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 smash.
The flies can weaken a tree's natural defenses and make it very vulnerable to other pests and diseases, and these pests are especially a threat to the agricultural crops. In this first graph, I used the information from the National Invasive Species Information Center and their pest trackers to show the growth of the spotted lanternflies versus the amount being eradicated. The blue part represents the number of spotted lanternflies being eradicated from 2014 to 2020. Behind it, representing a much steeper incline, is the green chart that represents the grand total of the spotted lanternflies in the same years. The percentage of spotted lanternflies being eradicated compared to the grand total never exceeded 7.6% from 2014 to 2020. In 2016, that percentage was as low as 1.7%, which creates the perfect opportunity for infestation growth. The maps below show where the majority of these spotted lanternflies are in our country. The dramatic difference between the two shows how relatively nothing is being done to prevent the exponential growth of the spotted lanternflies. This second graph from Integrated Pest Management shows an updated map from the Northeast coastal area and where there are spotted lanternfly infestations present. Finally, to assist you in finding spotted lanternflies, here is a chart of the key plant hosts and the months they would most likely be found on them. Keep your eyes out and help stop the spread of these nasty pests.